Hey everybody, Prepper Nurse One here. Today is Friday, October 6th, and I'm standing under the awning here because we're having a nice little rainstorm. And I gotta show you this. Here's, you can see her. There's Lucy's right there and Miss Bella looking to go in. So let me go walk over here real quick. I'm gonna just put this down so the screen don't get all screwed up. Like I said, part of my job here at the homestead is to be a professional doorman for my cats. So hold on 1 second, and I'll go back over here. Okay, so today is a rainy day at the homestead. Oh, and here comes Buddy down over here, coming down the driveway. So it's rainy, it was overcast. They definitely said it was gonna rain this afternoon, and it is. It is about 3:45 right now. So a couple things, several things I wanna talk about. Number one, as we do this video, I am 24 subscribers away from 10,000, which is absolutely amazing. I'm going to sit down tomorrow and talk about the giveaway. I'm going to be doing a giveaway. It's going to run for like maybe a week, and then I'm going to pull the winners, and there's going to be several winners because I want to do several giveaways. Here's another one. Hold on, buddy. Can you go to the house? So I'm going to be doing several winners to celebrate the fact that I've reached 10,000 subscribers. And I have to tell you all, this is absolutely amazing to me. I never would have anticipated 10,000 subscribers, so I really do appreciate it, and it means a lot to me. It really truly does. So that's off the top. So that video will come tomorrow, and I'm going to sit down with you guys and discuss everything in tomorrow's video. Secondly, we did the hike yesterday. And I mapped it out. I took the car out and went down. It was only 0.6 mile, okay? So, a couple things from that experience that I'm taking away from that. I have, and I'm going to show you here, my boots are fairly new. I had just recently bought these boots, so they're really not truly broken in yet. So, one thing I'm taking away, and it's only 0.6 mile, so it's actually nothing, to be honest with you. But one thing that I would take away from it is a really good pair of socks to give you extra padding. And it's like, and I would suggest wool socks because they're going to be the best thing for you as far as giving you that extra support in your boots or your shoes or whatever you're wearing. Okay. It felt good. I felt, you know, I mean, it's not that long of a hike. I weighed my pack out, and actually my pack is about 35 pounds. So it's not overly taxing. I was feeling it, but I'm trying to talk and walk at the same time. So if I was just focused on walking, it probably would have been easier. But I will definitely be doing some more of that. Okay, so now what I wanted to talk about, and it's funny because a lot of people put it in the suggestions, so, but I wanted to bring it up today, is if you're having to bug out in that situation and there's no vehicles available as far as cars, some kind of a hand cart, you could use a dolly to strap a lot of gear on and pull a dolly behind you. You're going to be able to pull a lot more weight that ways, okay? Another suggestion I would have, we got a lot of golfers out there, your cart thing that you use to put your golf bag in when you go to the golf course and pull your cart, you know, pull it behind you while you're walking through the golf course. That would be another thing that would be a good thing that you could actually use to load up with gear and pull that behind you. Now, if you could have a small cart, like I have this cart over here, that's obviously kind of big. But the thing is, if we loaded that cart up with gear and had two or three people pulling it, we could actually put several hundred pounds of gear into that cart. And I'm going to walk over here just so you guys can see what I'm talking about here. All right, here's a small cart, okay? Decent tires on it. I could put a couple hundred pounds of gear in that and run some ropes and stuff like that so that we would be able, with several of us, to pull it, and you would be able to pull that behind you. Now, that would be something that you would obviously have to use on a road. You probably would not be able to drag that through the woods, but you know, so if, or you know, look around your property, look what you have. If you have, you know, any kind of a cart that you can have, even like a wagon. As we grew up as kids, you had your radio flyer wagons. You know, you could load a wagon up, a small wagon like that, and get a lot of gear in there, and it's not going to be the strain on you pulling that behind you is if, you know, instead of actually having something that you're humping on your back. So there's other ways, obviously, that you can take a lot of gear with you. You can, you know, get one of the smaller carts that they use for gardening. You could get a lot of gear in that. It's got the bigger tires, would be able to go through the terrain better and stuff like that. Something else it's a possibility of being able to use, okay? So there's a lot of different possibilities to be able to do that. And so it's just a matter of innovation, looking what you have, what could work, what could not work. But you're going to be able to move a lot more weight. And like I said, you know, if you're got a cart, you know, and you're on the roads, that's a doable thing. Taking it through the woods is a little bit more difficult, okay? But again, it's going to depend on what you need, how many people that you have with you, what's the, you know, the physical capacity of these people. Now, again, I'm going to be doing some more hikes, and I got some other things that I want to talk about with you guys on how all of us, myself included, can be in better shape and practice ahead of time before an SHTF situation happens that we're not caught with our pants down and, oh my God, what am I going to do now? All right, that's the main reason behind a lot of what I'm talking about. And I'm going to show you. Like I said, I'm going to get out there and I'm going to do it myself. And I was going to do a hike this afternoon, but, you know, and here's the other thing. Okay, now it's raining. That's not going to stop you from walking. If you're walking and you have to go someplace or you're trying to get to someplace, the weather is not going to stop you. So now do you have that rain gear with you as well to be able to keep you so that you're not miserably soaked through to the bone and having to deal with foul weather, okay? So that's something to think about as well. Do you have that rain gear that's going to be able to afford you that you're not going to be completely... I mean, because, you know, as we all know, if you get wet, you can catch a chill. And, you know, that's in an SHTS situation, that could lead to death, okay? Lead to hypothermia, and then you're going to die. And, you know, it's like that's the last thing you're going to want to do. You're going to want to try to keep your strength as best you possibly can. You know, have a variety of different things in your pack. You know, have your energy bars so that you have that quick energy. And, you know, have your legacy foods in there, you know, your freeze-dried foods, so that at the end of your hike, wherever you end up that day and you got your fire going, you can, you know, heat up some water, pour in that legacy food, and heat that bad boy up, and you got a decent meal, and it's a nice, tasty meal on top of it. That's really, really important, okay? You know, having different things in your stuff, you know, you're going to try to want to go as lightweight as possible, as we discussed in yesterday's video. Like I said, I plan on doing some longer walks, obviously. Yesterday was just a demonstration to kind of show you. And I got some other things I want to talk about, and I got a challenge for you guys as well coming up that I want you to do, which I'll probably be doing that this coming week as well, or probably maybe I might do something on Sunday. I don't know yet. We'll see. But I have a challenge for you guys out there, and we're going to discuss that while I'm on a hike. I'm going to be doing another hike. You know, I'm going to be doing several hikes here, and I'll be doing some video and talking to you guys while I'm doing these hikes. Because like I said, I need to get in better shape than I am, just like everybody else. There's a lot of us out there that are not in phenomenal shape. But anyway, so here we are. It's Friday. It's the weekend coming up here. I want to make sure that everybody's safe, that you continue to stay focused, stay smart. And like I said, it's just there's so many different ways to prepare and be ready. Physical health is a big part of that as well, okay? And, you know, I'm just as guilty as anybody else. You know, I'm not in the best shape that I possibly can be. And I'm planning on doing something about that. And so, you know, watching what I eat, moderating what I'm taking in, and trying to get some form of exercise. And I figure a nice hike with my pack on is going to be a great form of exercise. And plus, it gets me mentally prepared for what I need to be prepared for if I need to. Okay? Anyway... So I'm going to cut this video off right now. Like I said, tomorrow I'm going to be sitting down and talking about the giveaway, what exactly I'm giving away for the giveaway and stuff like that. And it's absolutely amazing that here we are right on the cusp of 10,000 subscribers. It's absolutely amazing. So remember, guys, hug and kiss the ones you love. Tell them every day. Tomorrow is not guaranteed. We never know what's going to happen. And remember, STD, it's one step at a time, one thing at a time, and one day at a time. Work towards your prepping goals or whatever other goals that you have, your off-grid goals, whatever you're trying to accomplish. You work at that methodically, and you're going to get there, okay? Stock up on that food, guys. I mean, that's key. I'm telling you, it's paramount, first in my mind, okay? So I will talk to you all tomorrow. I hope everybody has a wonderful weekend. Spend it with people that you care about, because that's what it's all about, okay? I will talk to you all tomorrow. Prepper Nurse went out for now.